Thanks for watching this training video. We have recently upgraded Rivage PM series to version 6, and one of the key new features is called Genius Lab, where we can program macros, shortcuts, and customized workflow enhancements. Let me show you how to get started with programming your own macros. We'll begin with something really simple, then add a few more operations and conditions as we go along. Let's use an example that's relevant to my own life as a weekend woodwind player. Imagine we have a saxophonist who also has a flute. Two microphones are required due to the different size and sonic nature of the instruments, but only one mic is needed at a time. Let's link the on keys so that when one channel is switched on, the other goes off. Find Genius Lab in the setup menu. In the macro list tab, touch create, and you will see a new macro title appear. Touch this title to begin editing. First, let's rename it. Sax, not flute. Next, we're going to use the capture function. Touch capture at the bottom of the screen. Check it's on and make sure it's all clear. Then press on for the sax channel and press off for the flute channel. You'll see these two operations in the capture list. Touch the first operation for sax on and import it into the trigger list. Touch the second operation for flute off and import it into the action list. Now let's switch the macro on and test it. In the macro list, make sure Genius Lab is on with the switch at the top right. Notice the status of this macro is green, meaning it's enabled and the action has been triggered. If I switch the sax channel off, the macro status will turn orange, meaning it's still enabled but is waiting for the trigger. So let's manually switch on the flute channel and then watch what happens when I switch on the sax channel. Let's do that again and see the flute channel automatically switches off and the status of the macro becomes green again. That's great. The next step will be to get the flute on key to switch off the sax channel. Let's create another macro and call it flute, not sax. So now we're going to capture the on and off operations as before. Sax off, flute on. And the flute on will be the trigger, sax off will be the action. Enable this macro, and then we'll see that we can never have both channels on at the same time. Though, good for safety, we have allowed both channels to be off. Now let's learn about conditions. Perhaps we want this behavior to be disabled when we're in a sound check and are playing back a multi-track recording. So we can add the virtual sound check function as a condition. In the macro edit screen, open capture. Now in the patch menu of another screen, open the recording patch and enable virtual sound check. Now import this line into the condition table. Though, we want it to only work when VSC is off, so touch the line in the condition table to edit it and change the value to off. Enable the macro again and notice that the status is now blue. The condition for operation has not been met. So now we can operate the sax and flute channels independently again. But as soon as we disable the virtual sound check, the condition for the macro becomes favorable again and it operates as before. VSC will still be remembered in the capture list. So let's also import it into the other macro to complete this step of our programming. Well, this is great, so long as these channels are visible in the fader bays. What if they are hidden in another layer, and you want to quickly make the change between flute and sax without changing the fader layers? How about using a user-defined key? You could assign the trigger of pressing the key to cause the desired action. However, these keys have an unlatched behavior, so you would need to keep your finger held on the key to hear the flute. Let go, and it will return to the sax. So, we need a bit of extra logical thinking. We can program a macro for the user-defined key to turn its LED on after it is pressed, and another macro to turn the LED off. Then we can use the LED as the trigger to switch channels on and off. This needs three macros, but it's pretty quick. See if you can follow me. Create a new macro. And we're going to call this user-defined key 4. On. Now let's open the capture window and press the key. I want bank C, key 4. Now import this as a trigger. But notice it is set as released, but we should change this to pressed. Touch the trigger to edit it and change the value to pressed. Now we need to add a condition and an action to turn the key's LED on. Touch the plus button to add a condition. Choose user defined as the category and then the function as key's LED state. Choose the correct key, so bank C, number 4, and set the value to off. Create a new action with the same user define, keys LED state, and remember it's key C, 4, but set the value to on. So, if the LED is off when the key is pressed, the LED will turn on. Next, we need another macro for the LED off action. So, close the macro edit window and duplicate this macro. Edit the name to UDK 4 off. Then change the condition's value to on and the action's value to off. So let's enable these two macros and check that the LED works. As we press it, it changes from off to on. The LED has a latching behavior, exactly as we wished for. Actually, we didn't need to create that last macro. There is an easier method using a different operator. So, disable the two macros and edit the UDK on macro. Edit the action and select the operator as toggle. Then disable the condition as it's not needed anymore. Toggle will alternate the switch's status between on and off each time it is pressed. Switch on the macro and check that it works. We can create one more macro to complete our programming where the LED status triggers the sax and flute channel on-off action. So create a new macro and label it UDK4LED. Open the capture list, press the user-defined key, and import the LED state as a trigger. Now press the on key for the sax and flute channels and import them both as actions. So when a user-defined key LED turns on, the sax channel will switch on and the flute channel will switch off. We will want the opposite action when the LED turns off. And there's a shortcut to program that. Touch reverse action at the top of the list and copy the actions. Edit the actions so the sax channel turns off and the flute channel turns on. So now we have both action and reverse action in the same one macro. Let's enable the macro and test that it works. Next, you may wish to add a text label and color to the user defined key to indicate its function and status. You may be able to work that out for yourself from the list of available actions. Or look out for one of our next training videos which will teach you the method. Note that almost all parameters can be captured and added as a trigger, an action, or a condition. Faders, sends, dynamics, EQs, gains. So you can program some quite sophisticated macros while the actions can have wait times and fade times added. Enjoy creating your own shortcuts, as simple or as complex as you like. Ah, and don't forget the QR code shown in the About tab, and look out for more training videos and additional examples of how Genius Lab can help you work more efficiently. See you soon.